everyone, welcome to Math Quiz. In this video, let's see how to calculate optimum assignment schedule for a given assignment problem using Hungarian method. For that, let me take an example. Solve the following assignment problem. Here, jobs and machines are given. So, here number of jobs are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and corresponding column we have A, B, C, D, E as machines. Now, look at the number of rows. Here the number of rows is equal to 5. Since we are having 5 rows and number of column is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Also the number of columns is also 5. So the number of rows is equal to number of columns. So it is a balanced assignment problem. So the given problem is a balanced assignment problem. So we have to apply Hungarian method to find the optimum assignment schedule and its corresponding minimum cost. So the first step is we have to check whether the given problem is a balanced assignment problem or not. If it is balanced, we have to proceed to next step of Hungarian method. If it is not balanced, we have to make the unbalanced assignment problem to balanced, and then we have to proceed on to step 1 to Hungarian method. So the given problem given here is a balanced assignment problem. Since it has 5 rows and 5 columns, so both are equal, so it is a balanced assignment problem. So we move on to step 1 of Hungarian method. So the first step is we have to check whether each row has at least one zero element. Here row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 doesn't have any zero element. So we have to choose the minimum element from each row and subtract it from its corresponding row elements. So we have to choose the minimum element of each row first. So row minima. The first row, 5 is the minimum element. In the second row, 6 is the minimum element. In the third row, 2 is the minimum element. And the fourth row, 9 is the minimum element. And fifth row, 6 is the minimum element. Now, we have to subtract these minimum elements from its corresponding row elements. Now, we have to subtract the minimum element from its corresponding row elements. So, let's start with the first row. So, 5 is the minimum element. Let me subtract 5 from the first row elements. So, 10 minus 5, 5. 5 minus 5, 0. 9 minus 5, 4. 18 minus 5, 13. 11 minus 5, 6. The second row, 6 is the minimum element. So, 13 minus 6, 7, 9 minus 6, 3, 6 minus 6, 0, 12 minus 6, 6, 14 minus 6, 8. And for the third row, 2 is the minimum element. So 3 minus 2, 1, 2 minus 2, 0, 4 minus 2, 4 minus 2, 2. Again 4 minus 2, 2, 5 minus 2, 3. And for the fourth row, 9 is the minimum element. 18 minus 8, 9, 9 minus 9, 0, 12 minus 9, 3, 17 minus 9, 8. 15 minus 9, 6. Next, for the last row, 6 is the minimum element. 11 minus 6, 5. 6 minus 6, 0. 14 minus 6, 8. 19 minus 6, that is 13. 10 minus 6, 4. Now, after row reduction, that is after subtracting minimum element of each row from its corresponding row elements, we have at least one zero in each rows. Let us do the same process for column wise too. Now, we have to check whether each column has at least one zero element. For that, look at the first column. So, in this column doesn't have any zero element, so you pick the minimum element. So, we have to write down the column minima here. So, one is the minimum element. Second column has zero element, so leave it. Third column also have zero element, leave it. And fourth column doesn't have any zero element, so choose the minimum element from the third column, that is 2 is the minimum element. And the last column also doesn't have any zero element, so here 3 is the minimum element. Now we have to subtract these minimum elements from its corresponding column. So let's start with the first column. So we are going to subtract 1. So 5 minus 1, 4, 7 minus 1, 6, 1 minus 1, 0, 9 minus 1, 8, 5 minus 1, 4. So let's write down the second column as it is, since it has already 0 element, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0. And also the third column also as it is, because it has 0 element already. So 4, 0, 2, 3, 8. And for the fourth column, 2 is the minimum element. So let's subtract from its corresponding column element. So 13 minus 2, 11. 6 minus 2, 4. 2 minus 2, 0. 8 minus 2, 6. 13 minus 2, 11. And for the last column, 3 is the minimum element. So let's subtract from its corresponding column elements. So 6 minus 3, 3. 8 minus 3, 5. 3 minus 3, 0. 6 minus 3, 3. 4 minus 3, 1. Now, each row and each column, after row reduction and column reduction, has at least one zero element. So now the matrix is ready for making assignments. So after row reduction and column reduction, each row and each column has at least one zero element. So now we are going to make assignments. So now, how we are going to give an assignments? Don't give assignments here and there as you like. For that, I'll just give you a short trick of giving assignments to zeros. For that, I'm just giving you an idea about how to give an assignment. We always give the first priority for the row which has minimum number of zeros. So our first assignment is made for the row which has minimum number of zeros. You just keep that in mind and just write down the number of zeros in each row here. So no need to write it here. You just keep it in mind and proceed further. That's enough. That's for your understanding purpose. I write it outside of the square matrix. Okay. So the number of zeros in the first row is only 1. Here the number of zeros is 1. Here we have 4 zeros, and for the third row only 1 0, and for the last row 1 0. So first row, second row, fourth row and fifth row has only 1 0. So we give the first preference to either first, second, third or fourth. Now I am going to give the first assignment in the first row. So assignment is made by make a square around a zero element like this. After making assignment, this indicates that the assignment is made. After making assignment, we have to cross off. We have to cross off the zero elements in the corresponding row and column. In its column we have 3 0, so we have to cross the zero elements, and its row wise it doesn't have any zero, leave it. So this indicates an assignment is already made by cross of the zero, which indicates then assignment is already made in this column, so no need of making further assignments here. So after making assignment, you have to cross off all zeros in the same row and same column. Next, so first row has only one zero, so I make assignment here. Next, I move on to the second row, so it also has only one zero, so here I make an assignment. Now check, is there any zero in its corresponding row and column? In the same row and column it doesn't have any zero, so move on to the next step. Now here in the third row we have 3 zeros, fourth row and last row, fifth row doesn't have any zero, so now I am going to make an assignment here. Here you have three chances, either you make an assignment here or here or here. Arbitrarily I have to choose this point and make an assignment here, and you have to cross off the zero elements in the same row and also same column. This column wise doesn't have any zero, so leave it. So now we make an assignments, but the fourth row and fifth row doesn't have any assignments. So which means the current assignment schedule is not optimal. So we move on to the next step. What we are going to do in the next step is you have to draw minimum number of lines to cover all the zeros. For that we follow a certain procedure. So as a first step, mark the row which doesn't have any assignments. Here these two, fourth and fifth row, doesn't have any assignments, so we have to mark these two rows. This is your first step. And the second, we have to mark the fifth row too. So mark the rows which doesn't have any assignment. So this is what your first step. So first I have to mark the fourth row and also mark the fifth row. Then let me take first the first here. So in this row, look at, is there any zero elements? Here there is a zero element, so you mark the corresponding column. This is what the third step. So you mark the column which has zeros in the marked rows. And then next, after marking this column, you look at the column and check, is there any assignment made in that column? So here there is an assignment, you mark the corresponding row. This is what the fourth step. So mark the assignment, mark the row which has assignment in the marked column. Mark the row which has assignment in the marked column. This is your fourth step. After completing this, so look at this last row too. So now look at this row. Check, is there any zero element? Yes, there is a zero element. So this is what the column that we have already marked, so no need to mark it again. So, and also it has an assignment here, already we have to make a mark here, so no need to mark it again. So here both of the rows having zero elements in the same column. So we have completed these steps and proceed to the next step. Now I am going to draw a straight line through all unmarked rows and marked columns. So now I am going to draw a straight line through all unmarked rows These two are the unmarked row. Second and third row are unmarked one. First, whereas first, fourth, fifth one are marked rows. So I have to draw a straight line through unmarked rows and marked column. The second column alone is the marked column. So I have to draw a straight line through the second column. After doing this, we have to choose the minimum element. We have to choose the minimum element not covered by any of the straight lines. Here the elements not covered by any of the straight lines is 4, 4, 11, 3, 8, 3, 6, 3, 4, 8, 11, 1. These are all the elements not covered by any of the straight lines. So among these you have to pick up the minimum element. Here the minimum element is 1 is the minimum element. Now what we are going to do is, you have to subtract this minimum element from all uncovered elements. So you have to subtract the minimum element from all uncovered elements. So from these elements you have to subtract 1, and you have to add this minimum element to the point of intersection of the straight lines. So this is the point of intersection of the line, so you have to add 1 with 3, and this is also another point of intersection of two lines, so you have to add 1 with this point. So you have to add 1 with these two points alone, because these two are the point of intersection of the two straight lines. So, and leave the remaining elements as it is. So you have to leave the remaining elements as it is. So this is what the procedure we have to follow next. 4 minus 1, 3, again, 4 minus 1, 3. First write down the elements subtracted from the minimum elements. So I am going to write it first. So 11 minus 1, 10, 3 minus 1, 3 minus 1, 2. Next, coming to the fourth row, 8 minus 1, 7, and 3 minus 1, 2, 6 minus 1, 5, 3 minus 1, 2. And for the last row, 4 minus 1, 3. Next here, 8 minus 1, 7. 11 minus 1, 10. 1 minus 1, 0. Now we have to subtract all the uncovered elements from its minimum element 1. Next, what we are going to do next is, we have to add this minimum element to the point of intersection of the straight lines. That is, we have to add 1 to these two positions alone. So 3 plus 1, 4. Next, 0 plus 1, 1. And write the remaining elements as it is. So here you have 0. Next, here 6, 0, 4, 5. For the third row, 0, 2, 0, 0. Here you have 0 and 0. Now again we are going to make an assignment. For that, as usual procedure, you just keep in mind that we give the first assignment for the row which has minimum number of zeros. So the first row has only 1 0, so no need to write number of zeros outside of the square matrix like this. Just for the understanding purpose, I write it here. Okay. So for the second row, only 1 0. Third row has 3 zeros. Fourth row has only 1 0. And last row has 2 zeros. So either we give the first assignment. Now I am going to choose the first row for my first assignment. So I am going to give the first assignment for the first row. After making assignment, cross all the other zeros in the same column and row. So in this column we have 2 0, and row wise we doesn't have any zero. So you cross the 2 zeros along its column wise. Next, I'm going to give the second assignment for the second row to this position. So check, is there any zero in its corresponding row and column? There is no zeros. So go to the next step. So now we make an assignment. Either we have two options where we are going to give the first assignment. So either for the third row or the last row, because the third row has three zeros, I have to choose the last row first. So I am going to make an assignment for the last row since it has only one zero. So after making assignment, cross all the other zeros in the same column and row. So column wise it has only one zero, row wise it doesn't have any zeros. And next, the last option is for the third row. It has two zeros. Either I am going to make assignment here or here. So arbitrarily I have to choose this position and cross the remaining zeros in the same row and column. Row wise it has only one zero, column wise it doesn't have any zero. So we complete the procedure for making assignments now. Now check whether all the rows has an assignment. So first, second, third row has an assignment, whereas the fourth row doesn't have any assignment. So fifth row also has an assignment. So now this means that the assignment schedule is not optimal. So we proceed on to the next step. What we are going to do is, you mark the row which doesn't have any assignment. This is the row, fourth row doesn't have any assignment. This is why the first step we have followed. So in this row, check, is there any zero elements? So here is a zero element. So you mark the corresponding column. This is what the second step. So mark the column which has zeros in the marked rows. Okay. As a next step, you look at this column. In this column, check, is there any assignment is made? Yeah, here is an assignment. So you mark the corresponding row. This is what your third step. So mark the row which has assignment in the marked columns. This is the third step. After doing this, we have to draw straight lines through all unmarked rows and marked columns, which gives you the minimum number of straight lines cover all the zeros. So now I am going to draw a straight line through all unmarked rows. The second, third, fifth are unmarked rows, whereas first and fourth row was marked row. So I am going to draw a straight line through all unmarked rows and marked column. The second column is the marked column. So after drawing a straight line, what is the next step is, you have to pick the minimum element uncovered by any of the straight lines. So the elements uncovered by any of the lines is 3, 3, 10, 2, 7, 2, 5, 2. These are all the elements uncovered by any of the straight lines. Among these, you have to pick up the minimum element. Here the minimum element is 2 is the minimum element, isn't it? So we have to subtract these two from all uncovered elements, and you have to add these two with the point of intersection of the straight lines. So these three are the point of intersection of the straight line. So at these three points alone, you have to add 2 and leave the remaining elements as it is. Now I am going to subtract first. So 3 minus 2, 1. Next, 3 minus 2, 1. 10 minus 2, 8. 2 minus 2, 0. Next, leave the second and third row. And coming to the fourth row, 7 minus 2, 5. 2 minus 2, 0. 5 minus 2, 3. And 2 minus 2, 0. So after doing this, let us now subtract this minimum element to the point of intersection of the straight lines. So this is the point of intersection of the straight line. So add 2. So 4 plus 2, 6. And next, this is the element point of this already 1 here. So 1 plus 2, 3. Next here, this is also a point of intersection of the two straight lines. So we have to add the minimum element 2 with a 0. So 0 plus 2, 2. And then leave the remaining elements as it is. So now we have to write down the remaining elements. So 0 here and here 6. For the second row, 0, 4, 5. And for the third row, 0, 2, 0, 0. And for the fourth row here, 0. And for the last row, 3, 7, 10, 0. So after doing this, again we are going to make an assignment. As usual, you have to count the number of zeros in each row and give the first assignment for the row which has the minimum number of zeros. So I am just writing down the number of zeros outside of the matrix like this for your understanding purpose. No need to write it here. You just keep that in mind and make an assignment, okay? So first row has 2 zeros, second row has only 1 zero, third row has 3 zeros, fourth row has 0, 3 zeros, and the last row has only 1 zero. So either we are going to make an assignment for the second row first or the fifth row first. So arbitrarily I have to choose the second row first. Now I am going to make an assignment for the second row first. After making assignment, cross all zeros in the same column, and row. In its column it has only one zero, row wise doesn't have any zero. So cross the zero elements. Next, after making assignment for the second row, let us move on to the last row. Because it has only one zero, so I am going to give the next assignment here. So after making assignment, cross the all zero elements in the same row and column. So in the same column, it has 3 0. I have to cross off the zero elements. And row wise, it doesn't have any zero, so leave it. Next, we have to give an assignment either for the first row or fourth row, because first and fourth row alone have only one zero. So arbitrarily I have to choose this and give an assignment. So cross off the remaining zero elements in the same column and row. Column wise it has only one zero, row wise it doesn't have any zero. Next, I am going to make an assignment for third row. Third row has two zeros. So I have two options, either I make an assignment here or here, so I have to choose this position. So cross the remaining zero elements in the same row and column. Now check whether each row has an assignment. If it is not, you move on to the next step. So here first, second, third row has an assignment, but the fourth row doesn't have any assignment, whereas the last row has an assignment. Now check whether each row has an assignment. Here, except the fourth row, all the rows have an assignment. So fourth row doesn't have any assignment. So what we are going to do now is, you just mark the row which doesn't have any assignment. So the fourth row doesn't have any assignment. So this was the first step we are going to follow. So after making after marking the fourth row, then check, is there any zeros in this row? So there are zeros in three positions. So you mark the three columns. So here it has zero, so you mark this column. Here also it has zero, so mark this column. Here also in this position it has zero, so mark this column. So this is what the second step. And the third and fourth. So look at in this column, look at, is there any assignment made? So in this column there is an assignment here, so you mark this corresponding row. This is the fifth step. So for this column, check is there any assignment is made. So this is the position where you have an assignment, so you mark this row. This is the next step. Next you go to this column, so again you do the same process. So in this column, check is there any assignment made. So there is an assignment here, so you mark this corresponding row. This is what the next step, that is sixth step. And next you move on to the fourth one. So in this column, check whether is there any assignment made. So here is an assignment, so you mark the corresponding row. This is what your seventh step. So after doing all these steps, what we are going to do is we have to draw a minimum number of lines which cover all the zeros. For that you have to draw a straight lines through all unmarked rows. This is the only row doesn't have any mark. So draw a straight line through all unmarked rows and marked columns. So this is a marked column, and this is also a marked column, and this is also a marked column. Then after doing this, you have to choose the element which is uncovered by any of the, now you have to choose the minimum element not covered by any of the straight lines. Next, so 1 8 6 4 5 3 3 10, these are all the elements not covered by any of the straight lines. Among these, the minimum element is 1. So what we are going to do is you have to subtract 1 from all uncovered elements and add this 1 with point of intersection of the lines. This is the point of intersection of the line, so you have to add 1 with 3, and this is also a point of intersection of the line, so you have to add 1 with 2, and also here too you have to add 1 with 0, because these three points are points of intersection of the line. So you have to add the minimum element with these three elements and leave the remaining elements as it is. So this is what the next step we are going to follow. Now we have to first subtract the minimum element 1. So 1 minus 1, 0. 8 minus 1, 7. For the second row, 6 minus 1, 5. 4 minus 1, 3. And for the fourth row, 5 minus 1, 4. 3 minus 1, 2. 3 minus 1, 2. 10 minus 1, 9. Then next, you have to add this minimum element with the point of intersection of the lines. So you have to add 1 with these three positions. So for the third row, 3 plus 1, 4, 2 plus 1, 3, and 0 plus 1, 1. And leave the remaining elements as it is. So now we have to write down the remaining elements as it is. For the first row, 0, 1, 0. Second row, 6, 0, 5. 6, 0, 5. For the third row, 0. Here also we have 0. For the fourth row, 0, 0, 0. And for the last row, 2, 7, 0. Now we are going to give an assignment. Now we are going to give an assignment. For that, as usual, you just first give the assignment for the row where it has minimum number of zeros. So for that I am going to write the minimum number of zeros in each row outside of this square matrix. So first row has 3 zeros, second row has 1 zero, third row has 2 0, fourth row has 3 0, and the last row has only 1 0. So either I'm going to give my first assignment for the second row or the fifth row. So I'm going to first give my first assignment in the second row and cross the remaining zero elements in the same column and also row wise. Row wise it doesn't have any zero, column wise it has 1 0, so cross the zero element. Next assignment is for the fifth row, since it has only 1 0 element. So you make an assignment, after doing this cross the zero elements in the same column and also row wise. Row wise it doesn't have any zero, column wise it has 2 0. I cross the zero elements. Next assignment I am going to give it for the fourth row, because fourth row has only 1 0, whereas the third row and first row has 2 0. So I am going to give my next assignment here, since it has only 1 0. So after making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same column and row. Next I am going to give my next assignment for the first row, because the first row has only 1 0 element, whereas the third row here has 2 elements. So I'm going to give the next assignment in the first row. So after making assignment, cross the remaining zero elements in the same row and column, and we have only one option here for the third row. So you just make an assignment here. Now look at the matrix, check whether each row has any assignment. Now look at the matrix here. All the rows has an assignment, and also all of these, also all columns have an assignment. So the current assignment is optimum one. So we are going to learn now, write on the optimum schedule for this problem. So we arrive at a solution, and we have to write down the optimum solution and corresponding cost associated with it. So the optimum assignment schedule is jobs to machines, isn't it? So the question is, which job is assigned to which machine with a minimum cost? So job one to machine A, next 2 to C, next 3 to D, next 4 to B, next 5 to E, so this is what the optimum schedule. Next we have to calculate the cost associated with it. For that we just look at the given cost matrix, and we have to write down the cost associated with this portion. So look at the portion A, C, D, B, E. So we need the portion, the cost for this portion A, C, D, and for B, E. So A, C, D, B, and E. So this is what the questions we have make assignment using Hungarian method. And the cost, original cost associated with it is 10, 6, 4, 9, 10. 10, 6, 4, 9, 10. By adding all this, we get 10, 16, 20, 29, 39. So this was the cost associated with this assignment schedule. Hope you got a clear idea about how to find an optimum assignment schedule for a given assignment problem using Hungarian method. Thanks for watching. See you again in my next video.